It's always going to happen, yeah.
I know, sometimes I kind of put my hands there.
We're gonna watch the snake eat the lizard. He's in a creep up.
I used to use a roller. I don't know what it is, but I used to use a roller to shoo the lizard to him.
She leave him out there, he'll creep up behind him. Oh, you should leave him right there because he's gonna come behind him. There he goes, leave him. He smells him.
Sometimes he follows the stick that I put in there.
That's funny.
Because the scent's on the stick from touching him. I guess he break his leg.
I mean, a lot of times I just put the lizard in and walk away, and when I go back, he's gone. I don't really mess with him.
He's gone by the neck.
He's eating his dinner. That's his dinner. That's his food. That's what he has to eat to survive.
His neck until he dies, and then he starts eating it, I guess. Ain't that how they do it? They just bite their neck until they suffocate them?
Mm-hmm.
Or break all their bones or something?
Well, usually pythons just wrap their whole body around them and squeeze them.
He only does that little, you see in the beginning, that little quick wrap, and then this is pretty much what he does. And then he'll start to eat it head first. Yeah, did you see him flip around in the beginning? Flip around? Yes. You gotta go pee pee?
Yeah, you turn him, he spun him around and grabbed him.
A crab. A two-worm.
I know it's hard because I have been a few weeks, and I can kind of tell most of the time when he's out and about a lot, I'm like, he's hungry.
The lizard's still breathing. It's like it's choking it out, like.
You thirsty? You want water?
Yes.
Yeah, here. Are you okay?
That's your dump it in the cage.
And Jamie wanted to record the snake eating the lizard.
And now it's putting its head
so
in.
So now he's putting the head in his mouth. You got a potty? Come on, I'll show you. See how long it actually takes him to eat it. Sometimes I come, it's gone so fast, I just see a fat belly. I'm like, wow. I'm going to the airport now.
All better?
Tristan got referred to the, remember the feeding therapy? Because of him being picky at eating. Try that again. Yeah. I mean, he's getting it. Lizard now.
Let me help you push it up. There you go. Popsicle. Good?
Yeah.
Is it cold?
Yep, the lizard's almost gone. In the snake's belly.
Somewhere of the snake when it was real little eating, I think it was frogs. When I was feeding it baby frogs. Those tiny, it was tiny little frogs that were out there jumping in the road when I first caught the snake, when it was like the size of a worm. That's what I fed it, little frogs. I went out there and was catching little frogs. This piece right here is gonna fall. Right there, bite it. Right there. So it'll fall. There we go. And now we push up. Thank you.
looks like he's trying to break the tail off.
I know, that's what I was about to say. Is he trying to, like, break it off? Break the tail off? The snake trying to break the lizard's tail off. That's all that's left hanging out the mouth, but it keeps, like, kind of rubbing against the glass with the tail. Is that it? Did he pull in the last little bit?
Yeah, right there, and now it is.
He's like, thank you. Thank you for the food. His name is Charles, did you know that?
You named him Charles.
Michaela did a long time ago. I always forget, so I'm always like, what's his name again, Michaela?
Yep. It's going now. No, he's going to maneuver his body to push it down more. Bye, Charles.